Like what?
Your sketchbook. Don't tell anyone that. Okay? Never.
Can you tell us? Did she see the future or something important in the past?
What's going to think about me?
It's just huge.
Well, those are the clothes of a man with a story.
He smiled and he was sincerely happy to see her. I have hope. Really, I have hope. Bellamy, you came back. We came back from really worse than that. Oh! Yes? Don't go. Shh. Don't go. Raven! Are you crazy, my dear? You're gonna expose yourself? She let the door open? No. Okay.
They return to the same place like a fish that was caught and released.
You're
going to die here.
No.
The same place that he did.
Ooh, that would be a big bad event. You know what I said in the intro. She let him die.
Here it is. Yeah. Cry while you confess your sins.
Raven! I swear, if Raven is dying, she doesn't deserve that.
Shh. It won't bring you peace. Do it, Nikki.
No. No. No, shh. Good idea. I know. You're sad and all. You're gonna get better. Clark, every one of them, you can live with that. Leave. Ready? Leave. They are a family. And don't tell me that Bellamy is not missing. The art of the show, the leader, is not there for me. I love you, Andrew, really. You are making me smile during this episode. I'm not gonna thank him. Nah, don't even try to make me. She did it. It's really like I don't even want to watch it anymore. Why? Just kill him!
Because you're already dead.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Tired of the easy lines. This is not a soap, please. You can't be sure like the other time. Oh, I'm suffering. I'm still waiting for a big reveal, you know, at the end, because of the fact that they are playing with time. Like, at the end, we're gonna discover something that happened before all of that, and which is gonna explain a lot of things.
I know I can start the last one.
Start it, not fight it. You know the difference?
I'm so proud.
You're gonna begin this war.
No, volunteer. He needs a lifeblood.
Oh, so great! Kill him, just kill him. Can we stop with Shadeda and the Shepherd during this episode? Yes, please.
We need him to get our friends back. Your friends.
Our friends, you said.
Hope
what about door. Octavia, your sister?
Take it. No.
Yes. Clark did it. Bellamy thinks that he's still alive because of this friend. He's gonna betray us for good. That's it. That's a big bad event.
Watch plant.
It's offline.
Is it Earth, that planet? You're lying. No.
There's your bridge. Go.
Now move.
You should have more faith.
Not in you.
You made your choice.
You're not letting him.
I really hope this new thing you believe in is worth it. Max,
let's go.
You're giving up on him, really? All of you? You can take him with you and stop the brainwashing, you know?
I said I wouldn't lose anyone else. But I have. You? That doesn't matter to you, though, does it?
Look, the pain in his eyes.
So much hurt together.
Oh, come on! What now? It's Maddie's book.
Come now.
Clark, Maddie isn't in danger. I'll make sure of that.
I know not taking that from Clark.
I am trying to save us all, Clark.
I'll kill Kevin. Cough and walk and go now.
Clark, oh, Clark, this isn't about Cadigan.
Don't make me do this.
Oh no, no, no!
You're not gonna shoot me,
Clark. No!
Not without that book.
She did that. The first time she did that.
You feel the need to protect someone you love so badly, you're willing to kill your closest friends, telling you that the fate of the entire human race is at stake. All that suffering. And then.
Stop, please stop! No, it's not. No, it's not dead. Nice. Dead. She knows how to shoot. I mean, she knows how to stop him without killing him. No, he's not dead. She's living without the book. She killed him for the book. I mean, she shot him for the book, and she's living without. Fuck you! I can't. I'm sorry, No, that's... Okay, in the art. Really, the art of the show, you're killing him. Clark is killing him. In the art. You. By a bullet in his heart. He is the heart of the show. All of these lies. You think you know what Monty said? You think what happened during that moment, you know, when she was ready to shoot him and she didn't do it because she couldn't. Right there, she could because of Maddie, because she was protecting Maddie to have a fucking book that she's not finally taking at the end. Are you fucking insane? Symbolic, you put a bullet in the heart of the heart of this show, and you're already expecting us fans to follow you, to be okay with that, to accept that. You're killing the heart of this show with a bullet in his heart. Are you so dumb? Are you so stupid? You just killed your show. You killed it. Fuck you, I don't care if I'm swearing, I don't care. No. I'm not accepting it, I mean, I just saw it. inevitable times. I don't know if I'm gonna keep all of them. That was a bullet into his heart. I mean, she knows how to shoot. She could have shot in another part of him to not kill him. But really, he's dead. Right there, he's dead. And she's crying. We are seeing her crying because she knows that she killed him. Episode 13. That's the development and the evolution that you want to make for one of your main characters. The one who, since the beginning of your show, was the leader of the 100, the heart of the show. You're letting him finish like that, like a fucking sheep, without... I mean, even if you want him to die during this final season, it's doing something great, you know, something important, something logical with the rest of your show, like I said, you know, protecting his sister or doing something great, important. No, you are letting him die like that, as a fucking disciple, as a fucking sheep, for a face that he found just 3 episodes ago. 3 months ago for him, really. And killed by Clark. That's the last fuck that you can do for the Belarc fans, for this fanbase. That's the last fucking fuck that you are giving to us. And that's the last one that I'm gonna take from you. When Octavia is gonna know that? When Clark is gonna say that to Octavia? If they are doing that, if the writers are nice enough to offer us that, when a sister is losing her brother, she's supposed to know it and she's supposed to cry. Are we gonna have that? Are we gonna have them mourning him? Are we gonna have a moment to honor this wonderful character that we are following, loving, seeing evolve and all since episode 1? Are we gonna have that? I'm not even sure. They're not gonna give us that, they're not gonna give him that. Because these fucking writers and producers made that clear since 2 seasons, the fact that they don't care about their characters, they are mistreating them, they hate Bellamy. Like really, some writers told so on Twitter since years now that the fact that they don't care about Bellamy, that's it, you proved it by giving him that hand. He's not doing anything honorable, he's not doing anything. He's dying like that. Like a disciple, like a fucking sheep. A bullet in his heart, killed by his best friend, while he was betraying them. After saying these lines that Belarc fans we love, that fans of the 100 we love, after seeing what Monty said, thank you for using that. Thank you for using these lines. How dare you? Using these lines during a moment like that. You really think that you are so clever and that you are so unpredictable by doing that, by making him dying like that? No. You are stupid. You are killing everything. All of the love that your fans maybe still had for your show, you just finished it. And don't come on the comments to tell me that they were forced to do so because of Bob's issues, you know, because he was missing. All of the fucking stories that they could have written, I'm not gonna say all of them, but please! Just use your imagination, just use your fucking head, and you're gonna discover a lot of different stories that they could have... Ta mère! I'm sorry, I'm tired of the word fuck, so I'm gonna swear a little in French just to evacuate, you know, the pressure. La putain de ta mère, de ta race, de ta grand-mère va te faire foutre enculé de ta mère. Connard! Mais quel putain de connard! Ah! Mais va te faire foutre! Toi et ta putain de haine contre tes personnages. I don't understand, I really don't understand how you can mistreat so much your own characters. The characters that you wrote, the characters that you made like that, the characters that you have since day one. How can you mistreat them so bad? So bad that you are making them dying like that. We have a lot of main characters who are dying into other shows and all. But they are treating that well, they are writing that well to honor the character, to make a big final moment with them. It was not that right there. Bellamy deserved better, for sure. This show deserved better. The fans deserved better. We deserve better than this end for Bellamy. Do you understand what I mean? We as fans, we deserve better than the end of this character like that. He was the fucking end of this show and you are killing him by a bullet in his heart. By Clark, I mean. How on earth are you doing that? Their fucking relationship, I don't care if you ship them or not, I don't care, but be honest, their relationship as a loved one or not, as best friends, their fucking relationship is the relationship with, maybe the Blake relationship is the relationship of this show, is really the one with, you know, taking this show with all for this show. Xandre, I mean, Xandre is a character and the show would be nothing without their relationship and without these two characters. You just killed one and you just killed one and you killed what their relationship was during all of these years. It meant nothing if at the end you finishing it like that, it meant nothing. I'm mad, I'm really mad at the writers, at the producers, and at me also to take it so bad. I mean, I'm saying since the beginning of this season that this is the worst season, that for me the end of the season 4 is a real end, that I'm just watching this show now for the character, that I don't love it anymore, that I don't care about the stories and all, I just want to know how it's gonna end. I'm seeing it since the beginning of this season and I'm still like that, I'm still finishing this episode like that. I'm mad at myself, I shouldn't care, I shouldn't cry. They don't deserve my tears, you know. They don't deserve me to cry. But I'm mad, I'm so mad. And I'm mad at myself, you know, to still involve my feelings into a show that I don't love anymore. The 100 really became that kind of relationship, love relationship, which is finished since a long time, but you are still there, you are still fighting for it, even if this person that you loved before is hurting you again and again. You are still holding on. It's really feeling like that. I'm tired of myself, I'm losing and crying at the same time. I don't even want to talk about the rest of the episode because it was so bad. So fucking illogical, everything that happened. Each time that they almost killed Shededa and they didn't do it, all of the times, all of these lines, oi 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 oi. Can you write it worse than that, really? All of what happened during this episode, except maybe for that final scene, could have happened really in one or two scenes. You used all of this episode for that? Oh, and Josephine who came back. Like, really? We have time to lose with her? With all of the stories that we have to resolve? With all of the characters? Dr. Santiago, he could have thought on his own, you know? He didn't need her for that. Like, This episode was lame and painful to watch, but the end, it's not painful, it's beyond that. Look at me, I'm really like that, like... And I think that during the episode I had hope for him to come back. I still have. I mean, if they wouldn't have killed him just like that, he was still seeing our friends. He had still a lot of trust, you know, in Claire. He was still doing and seeing a lot of stuff, making me think that hope was still there, he could come back. I'm sorry to say that, I still have hope. I still have this little baby, tiny, little baby, tiny hope that maybe is still alive because of the fact that they are playing with time. Can it be possible that we have a time situation and something is gonna be revealed at the end, like... Maybe I'm believing into that because I just watched Dark. And you know, in Dark, when we saw someone dying, in fact he was still alive because of the time situation. So maybe that's why I still have hope about that. Because also one of you told me on the comments that he was so sure that it was Bellamy who took Gaia. I have hope. How crazy and hopeless I am to still have hope that he's still alive. For once, I think that I'm gonna watch the trailer, you know, a sort of homecoming. You're on Earth? What? She screamed Bellamy? Oh no, magic. A sort of homecoming, it's because of the fact that they're gonna go back to Earth or a planet like Earth. I involved so much my time, my energy, my love in this show during the first seasons, even if during the last ones I was watching it without loving the show, the stories and all, and just for the characters. I mean, yes, I was watching it just for the characters now, and one of them just died treated like that by the writers. Why I should continue to watch it, you know? They are mistreating their characters and their fans by that so bad. That happened during this final scene was just fuck that they were giving to us. They gave us all of the fuck that they could give us during this final scene. I'm really like, three more episodes to watch. I can survive, you know, I can survive three more episodes. But I think that when you're gonna see me again for the 100, maybe I'm not gonna be into the same mood. Maybe I'm really gonna watch it without the same emotion, without the same... I'm gonna continue and I'm gonna make reaction videos for the end of this season because I made that promise to you and I want to finish it with you. But we're not gonna be into the same mood. The mood was really not good already, but now that's gonna be... Tell me, what did you think about this episode and how they killed him just like that? And I will see you for the next episode. Yeah! I'm really trying to make myself and maybe also you lost, you know, at the end of this video, but I'm not sure that I'm succeeding. It's all for the 100 for now, and that's better. And it's all for me for now, and it's better like that also. So bye for now. Bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine?
Hey.